Next, what will I write since we are going in the reverse order? 8 above 2. Then above 3 I'll write 7. Then above 4 I'll be writing 6. Above 5 will come only. And then here I'll write 4. Then 3 will come. Then 2. Then 1. And then here I'll write 0. So you can see at the bottom numbers are written in forward. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And on the top of this line we have written numbers in the reverse order. Like 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 and 0. Now something very interesting to see over here, that let's take the extremes now. Here it is 10 and 0, and here we have 0 and 10. Now if you add 0 and 10, the answer will come out to be 10. Or we can say if we add 10 and 0, then also the answer will be 10. Next is, if we add 9 and 1, or this side also, 1 and 9, the answer will be same, that is 10. Similarly, 8 and 2, 2 and 8, the answer will be 10. Same way 7, 3, 3, 7, addition of these two numbers will give 10. Same way 6 and 4, 4 and 6 will give the answer 10. 5 and 5 obviously will give 10. So these pairs will always give the answer 10. So let's jot it down. Let's write over here. 10 plus 0 will give the answer 10. Then 9 plus 1 will always give answer as 10. Similarly, 8 plus 2 will give 10 as the sum. Next is what? 7 plus 3 is equal to 10. Next will be 6 plus 4 will always be 10. And last will be 5 plus 5 will always be 10. So this is a way to remember that which two numbers will always give the sum as 10. I hope you have understood this trick. You are going to apply this whenever you are going to do addition sums.